أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين الذي سمي في السماء بأحمد وفي الأرضين بأبي القاسم المصطفى محمد اللهم صل على محمد طب القلوب ودوائها ونور أبصارها وعلى أهل بيته الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا اللهم صل على محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إلا المودة في القربى آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات اللهم صل على محمد For the love of Abba Abdullah Hussein, with the loudest of our voices, صلوا على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد For the love of Imam Jaffer Sadiq, صلوا على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد For the love of Imam Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, arwaquna lakul fida, sallu ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. First of all, we thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for gracing us and granting us with this great and wonderful moment, wonderful opportunity to continue to acquire the understanding of our religion. And today, as you all know, brothers and sisters, we are gathering this afternoon not for anything because of a program which is named Sufro of Imam Jaffer Sadiq. I want to take this opportunity first to look at the reason as to why we have this program. And then we take it back to the historical books, to the times of Ahl al-Bayt, and to our great scholars, their teachings, and see where it fits in. Then I will conclude by looking at the best way of having such a gathering. Because we don't want to do something to waste our time, and to waste our wealth, and to waste our precious energies. We want to do things that conforms with the teachings of Allah and the teachings of Ahlul Bayt. Sufro is like in Farsi, Sufre. Sufre means what you sit on down and put food there and eat. Myself, the first time I got an encounter with this was when I became a resident alim of Imam Hussein Mosque in Durban, South Africa. I was in Johannesburg. Nobody was doing it. Local Shias, they didn't know anything about this. Iranians, their center in Johannesburg, zero, nothing. Local South African Indians, nothing. I was in Iran, I studied many years, nothing. I never heard about it. But because in Durban, 60% of the population are from Pakistan and India. So when I was there, I was invited. Come, Fakir, Kundi of Imam, Nazar of Imam. Then I asked them, what is this? They said, no, this is special thing in the school of thought of Ahlul Bayt. Okay, I went. There was nothing much. It was just to eat and enjoy yourself and go back home. But then as a student, you cannot just leave it there. You have to make your own research. So I made a lot of research 5-6 years ago, not now. I contacted many scholars. I read so many books just to try to trace where this thing is coming from. There are three reasons, but none of those reasons can be traced in any book. You cannot trace them. There are three reasons. The second one, a little bit, but it is not authenticated by any scholar. The first one is the question of the death of Muawiyah. That Muawiyah died. But since you cannot come and just celebrate, just do it in the name of Imam Jaffer Sadiq. But when you look at the date, for instance, the best book to look at, maybe Yaqubi. Yaqubi mentioned Muawiyah died either in the beginning of Rajab or in the middle of Rajab, not at the end of Rajab. But now, for argument's sake, as I mentioned on Friday, if the program, which I don't think so, because it will not make sense for Ahlul Bayt, that we gather, we eat, we celebrate, because Muawiyah left this world, what does it add to our iman? It will not add anything to our iman. We rather have to focus on trying to get more iman rather than celebrating the death of somebody. Allah is the judge. He has done what he has done. It's between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that one, I don't think is a good reason to say we come together, we eat, because Muawiyah died. That's the first reason. The second reason is what most of those who speak, especially on a day like this, they quote, which is a long story. I cannot quote it, and I'm sure you read it. I'm just going to make ishara indication. That is the question of this woodcutter in Medina. He found himself with his wife and his son, and his main job was cutting wood and sell. He will make the wood into bundles and he will sell them to people. This is what is being quoted. And then his business was not flourishing. It was not going. I want you to listen very carefully, and you can go and make your own research, inshallah. Things became very difficult for him. Then he decided to leave Medina to another city. He left Medina to maybe for greener pasture, for him to be able to look after his family, his wife, and his son. Now, when he arrived in that particular village, whoever he met, the person would ask him, "What skills do you have?" Then he would tell them, "I have no any skills except wood cutting. I can go to the farm, cut wood, make them into bundles, and then I sell them." So he could not secure any job. He ended up doing the same job for himself. He promised his wife, who is in Medina, "I will send you money and I will come back and see you." But this did not go well for him. For 12 years, the wife did not even hear about him, because he was suffering and things were not going well. So now what happened was, the wife decided to say, "Let me start working." So she went around looking for job, and finally she got something to clean. I think one of the stories said, like the house of the palace of some chief or some princess, something. So she would be sweeping. So it happened that one day she was sweeping, and then she saw Imam Jaffer Sadiq and his companions were walking. This is the riwayah, but I'm not saying it's authentic, and you can go and check it. Imam Jaffer was asking his companions, "Which month are we in?" Then they said, "Rajab." Of course, Imam knew it's Rajab, but maybe he wanted to know. But some argument people said, why would Imam ask them, is it Rajab? But some who are defending the whole program, they said, no, Imam wanted just to find out from them, like the way Allah said to Ibrahim. Fine. Then they said Rajab. Then Imam asked them, which day is this day? Then they said, 22nd of Rajab. And this is where Imam said, then you make kheer, and then the other one, and then you put them into two containers, of course made out of flour, and then you sit down, you make with the wasila of Prophet alayhi salam, and then you do all your things, will be sorted. Your legitimate desires will be fulfilled by Allah. So the lady said, I overheard them. Then when I saw like that, I said, no man, this is a good thing for me to do, for Allah to help me. So the lady also went and did it. And all of a sudden the husband came back. I'm giving you just paraphrasing in short. And the husband came back, and then everything went all. From there they call it Nazar of Imam Jaffer Sadiq. But believe you me or not, you cannot find it in any book. Go to, for instance, Al-Dhahabi, which is a very good book, which we get a lot of things about Imam Jaffer. You will not find it. Go to Yaqubi, it's not there. It's more of culture, as I mentioned on Friday, than religious. And therefore you find it is mainly observed from the Asian intercontinental. You meet a Shia somewhere, somewhere you ask him, he said, I really don't know. So therefore, these are the main reasons as to why we celebrate. But the third one, to me, it makes sense. Although there is no any reasons, because it's my duty to tell you the position. I cannot say, fine, let's celebrate Kundi, fine. No. My duty as a scholar, I have to tell you the truth. Whether you've been doing it for a million years, this is the reality. And there is no harm in doing it at the end of the day. No harm. But there are bid'ah and innovations that are added to it. For instance, you make ladu and people put like 100 rings in it. This, how? If somebody come and see, wallahi, will laugh. How do you make food and then you put, some people even ahead, they put diamond into ladu. Allahu Akbar. Really, you know, maybe you don't suffer the way we suffer as scholars. Many youth, of course, I told you, and even elders, approach me about this thing. This past week, I received more. Friday, I received about 30 questions about this, and I told you on Friday. Up until now, I received close to 55 questions from this community about this. Sheikh, we've been doing. I said, no, according to my knowledge, maybe my knowledge is too small. But I contacted many people in Iraq, in Iran, those I trust. Just give me the trace of it. Even yesterday, because I was preparing to come and talk to you, there was no any reason. So therefore, doing it, as I said, there's no harm. It's good. In the name, every majlis for Ahlul Bayt has a great blessings. But we cannot make it a gospel truth like Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So therefore, masalli ala Muhammad. So therefore, when you do it, there are people which I heard, I've not seen. They said they've got a beautiful cloth, and people, when they make sajida, told, this is bid'ah. How do you put white, put cloth, nice food, let's eat, is good in the name of Imams. It's excellent, you get reward. No doubt, we are not wasting our time. But now there are certain things you do, you allow outsiders to talk more about us. Now you put this beautiful food and then you go down, you make sajda. Who are you making sajda to? Is it the cloth or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So therefore, continue, let's celebrate. But let's do it within a frame of Islamic teaching. No addition, no subtraction. Therefore, if you ask me, how do we celebrate it? This is my last point. I said there is a third reason, which to me is an excellent reason compared to first and the second. Second one is also good because definitely Ahlul Bayt, Allah give them a lot of blessings, no doubt. But the third one, some scholars mentioned, because I was reading about it. They said, no, because the birth of Imam Jaffer and that of Rasul is the same day. So normally on those days, preachers, even I can testify to that, we hardly speak about Imam Jaffer Sadiq. Therefore, it is a good, this, you see how people are clever. It is the best platform just to talk about Imam Jaffer Sadiq alayhi salam. If it is like this, then excellent, it's a great blessing. So therefore, I conclude by saying this. Let's celebrate it. Let's meet and eat. In the name of Ahlul Bayt. In the name of Imam Jaffer Sadiq. But it should not be a platform of competition. This one, I'm wearing beautiful clothes. That one, she said, no, your clothes is better than mine. This one said, the clothes is better than mine. It is to be a majlis for the zikr of Ahlul Bayt. If you want to succeed in it, when you start to eat, discuss about Allah and Ahlul Bayt. The moment the food is given, discuss about Allah and discuss about Ahlul Bayt. Then it becomes complete and perfect. And no harm. Food, you take it home, you eat, no problem. It's niyaz. Niyaz always has barakah. There is no problem. But to add something into it, to put ring, to put gold, to put diamond, to place it somewhere, this one, la hawla wa la quwwata lahu illa billah. It has no tail, it has no ears. We don't know about it. From the school of thought of Ahlul Bayt, we don't know about it. Let's celebrate it nicely so that we get reward from Allah. Therefore, I leave you with these points. And the best thing, the best way to do it, you see, Imam Jaffer is the epitome of knowledge. How much knowledge do you know about Imam Jaffer Sadiq? Imam had 4,000 students. We don't want to be his student. We want to be the student of his student. How much are we there? Abu Hanifa spent only 2 years with Imam Jaffer. But he said, لَوْلَ السَّنَتَيْنِ لَحَلَكَ النُّهْمَانِ. If not because of the 2 years that Abu Hanifa spent under Imam Jaffer Sadiq, he would have been in trouble. And today, he is the head of the Mazhab of Hanafi. You as a Shia, I as a Shia, how much have I learned from Imam Jaffer Sadiq? So for us to make good use of this program, Sufro, no problem, it's not haram. There is no harm in doing it. It's a blessing. You give people food in the name of Ahlul Bayt, it's a great blessing. Although we cannot trace it, that's my point. Remember Imam Jaffer Sadiq. Learn about Imam Jaffer Sadiq. Know more about him. If Hanifa spent only 2 years under him and he's got millions of people following him today in the world, what of you was born Shia and you born right from your first day until today? How much do you know about the biography of Imam Jaffer Sadiq? How much do you know? So therefore, let's celebrate it properly by getting to know more about Imam Jaffer Sadiq. And by eating that food in the name of Imam Jaffer Sadiq, and then it becomes a proper spiritual, social gathering where we will get reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to forgive us, inshallah. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to continue to inspire us with the understanding of Islam, inshallah. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it easy for us to be able to understand the true teachings of Islam. Because you know the harm which has been done to Shiism is that there are so many bid'ahs and innovation in this school of thought. And the enemies of Shias are capitalizing on the bid'ah and the innovation which is there in this school of thought. Al-Bayt don't need anything to be added to them. They are complete from the time of Rasulullah until the end. Wa akhir da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa alihi tawhirin.